It's Fran in the lab, blah, 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 blah. Well, last year I was on a quest for some rare light bulbs and bought a bunch. I'd actually haven't made all the videos of all the bulbs I bought. I just didn't want to have it be like all light bulbs last year, but when you search on eBay for something as common as a light bulb, you can get like all kinds of crazy things in the listings, no matter how many like special keywords you put in a chain. And one of those things that I kept running into repeatedly searching for light bulbs were mortuary bulbs or funeral home bulbs. And I thought, well, how can there be like a bulb just for a mortuary? Well, it turns out there is. And this is one of them. I just had to get one. like I said, these come up on eBay, and I really didn't know anything about it, but it turns out that these bulbs have been made for decades for special use in mortuaries, funeral homes, things like that, to illuminate corpses. I can't believe I'm making a video about this. Oh, okay, well, let's take a look at the light bulb, okay? All right, here it is. for those who are wondering if this is an LED bulb, it is not. This is a tungsten light bulb, and I'll explain in a second why that is. But yeah, and you notice this is a big bulb. It's not just big here, it's big here. This has what they call a mogul base. And the mogul base, it's like an E4039 size. It's much larger than the standard Edison, which you use this converter for. This is the standard Edison socket. It's much larger. And these sockets are, you know, they're intended for commercial bulbs, for light bulbs that are of much higher power, like in excess of like 1,000 watts usually. And this is also a three-way. You can see this little ridge here. It's a three-way because there's two different filaments. You've got a low-power filament, which goes between the common, which is on the threads, and this outer shoulder. That's the low-power filament. And then the medium filament is between the common and the tip. And then if you have the tip and the shoulder both on the hot and this to the common, then you've got both of the filaments on, and you're on high power, and that's how the three-way works. This is actually such a bright bulb that I've set it up just to go on the low power filament alone. And I did that by taking the converter here. You see inside the socket, there's a little tab on the bottom. This socket and this converter are just for a single filament bulb. But when you see that tab in there, I bent that up just to contact the ridge of the socket. So it only turns on the low power filament instead of the high power filament, which it would normally do if it hit the center. So yeah, but even on low power, let's see what we got here, low power is still 100 watts. So it's 100, 200, 300. So, okay, so three-way, 120 volts, yada, yada. 3,900 lumens, yada, yada. Okay, so the reason this bulb is tungsten became apparent to me when I turned it on. When I turn it on, okay. So, there we go, it's, all right, auto gain. So this puts out a lot of infrared. It's a 100 watt bulb, but it's very hot. Just, you know, even putting my hands like a foot away, it's like fireplace toasty. So there's a lot of infrared. So I suspect that the filaments might be sort of extra thick, so that they're not really glowing as brightly for the wattage that would bring their tone curve down into the redshifted if they, you know, and yeah, getting close to the bulb, it's like red hot. I can't get anywhere near it. And the red filter here is basically cutting off most of the blue side of the spectrum in favor of the red. So if I move the light bulb up here out of the way, I had to take off the auto white balance. So I still have a lot of daylight pouring through. I can't really illuminate it even with the shades down. So with the bulb, the bluish light is pointed up at the ceiling, and the red coating on the bottom is making a kind of a cherry red light glowing downward. And I read that the way that these are set up, they're set up on like tertiary lamps, that the, you know, pedestals, which they call mogul lamps, where they have the big bulb in the center. But basically, it's meant to be an open bulb, not in a like draped or anything like that, to directly shine this red light down to cover up the sort of greenish hue that we have when we are not alive. So there you go. It's a creepy red light. So if you have a bunch of these, you put them around your corpse that you want to look good, and there you go. Okay. Okay, that's it. I hope you learned a little bit about the glamour lighting that are employed for the dead. It's very specific. I do not want a funeral. I think it's ridiculous in this day and age that we mummify people and present them, you know, in funeral homes. I don't know why people want to do that. It's just sort of crazy. It's like the person's dead. It's like, it's a totemistic thing. I don't understand it. I don't go to funerals and stuff. I don't do the viewings. I think it's crazy. But there you go. Light bulbs for the dead. Who would have thunk it? All right, well, I'm very much alive and kicking, so I'll see you back here at the lab with something not so, morose, maybe? Who knows? But you never know. You never, ever know. Thanks to all the patrons on Patreon who are alive and kicking and keeping this channel alive and kicking. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Everyone on Patreon, thank you. I'll be back here at the bench real soon. Bye! In the lab. It's where I work. In the lab. Go berserk. My lab, it's where I work. Friend.